And this will kind of fast forward today. You're past 11,000 followers now. Yeah. So kind of just, what would you say is the way you grew? Like, how did you grow your Instagram?
Well, the photography community is pretty tight knit. A lot of people know a lot of other people. So I think that, you know, engaging in the community and talking to people is really, really important. And I think that's true for any industry. Like, every business is about making connections. And I think that the more connections that you make, the more successful your business will be. So I would try to find as many photographers as I could that I liked their work. And I would follow them. I would send them messages. I would make sure to comment on all their stuff. It was a grind, right? Like, Instagram has changed back in 2012 when it first started. It was really easy to grow because nobody was doing anything with it. It was like this new platform where people would post selfies. And I know tons of photographers that started back in 2012 where they have, you know, hundreds of thousands of followers now just because it was so easy to grow. They grew, you know, to 10K in 8 months. But nowadays it's a little bit harder. So you really need to put in the time and the effort. You need to be commenting on posts. You need to be liking, you need to be sending messages, replying to stories, even like just making those connections any way you can. So when I first started, I linked up, there was a Facebook group for school and there was another photographer in it. And I linked up with him and he took me on my first photo shoot ever. And that's probably the first photo on my Instagram. I think it's a guy sitting on a red BMW. And there's some greenery behind him. He's wearing like a black sweater or something like that. I think, if I remember correctly. If not, I deleted it and reposted it somewhere else. But that was the first photo I really ever took. And after I linked up with the other photographer, again, connections, that's kind of what pushed me to like do this as much as I could.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So did you ever do any, like, when you kind of grew up before photography, was there like a follow-on-follow play or was there like going through hashtags?
Yeah, there's a little bit of both. I mean, I think your first, you mentioned earlier, Casey Neistat said that your first 10,000 is the hardest. I think that your first 1,000 is the hardest. And then it goes to 10,000. But, I think up to, yeah, I did a little bit of the follow unfollow thing up until about 1,000 or maybe a little bit over that. Because it's effective. But it's not the greatest for your branding. It kind of sucks, and I'll admit it, like it does, it's kind of shitty. But it is effective, and in today's Instagram arena, you almost kind of need to. And I think that's why there's such a big market for it, is because it is so effective, it works. Especially with, like, you know, people selling bots or like whatever, they follow, unfollow for you. Huge industry for it. But other than that, yeah, I was going through hashtags, it was going through the tagged posts of feature pages, because a lot of, you know, younger photographers would tag the feature page in their photos and you could just scroll through and whatever else. So it was everything, man. I mean, I did whatever I could. I spent so much time on my phone just trying to grow it because I looked at it as an investment, right? Put the time in and hopefully it'll pay off.
Yeah. You talked about featured pages. Have you ever been featured by other pages?
Yeah, I've been featured on a couple pages. My goal when I post, I mean, I use feature hashtags. I use hashtags of feature pages and tag them in my post, but I don't do it to try to get featured. I find that they don't really do anything for you. Like, it's kind of cool. Okay, cool. Like, somebody liked my photo enough that they posted it on their page. Cool. But they don't really get you very many followers. They don't give you anything, you know? It's more just for them. So I got featured by a couple when I first started. I haven't been featured in a while, I don't think. But I don't try to get featured.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think there's like that misconception where you land on a big page like that features photos and they credit you for it, that you're just going to get like hundreds, thousands of followers, and it doesn't happen.
Yeah. You know, I know a photographer from Toronto and he took a photo of Niagara Falls. And it got featured on several feature pages with like millions of followers. And he said he maybe gained like 120 followers.
Yeah, which is nuts. And
yeah, it's nothing. Like, you know, this page has 4 million people following it and you gained 100 followers when they posted your photo. Like, it doesn't matter, mm-hmm. You know?
Because like, how many people realistically, like even just for yourself, when you're scrolling through Instagram, do you click on a picture that like see a picture you like, and then you expand the caption to see the photographer and like go in and follow him. Like,
yeah, I mean, I think I do it more than other people, just because it's, you know, my area. I like knowing, and I like finding new photographers and seeing their work. So if I see on a feature page is a photo that I really like, I'll check it out. I'll check out the photographer. If I really, really like them, I'll give them a follow. But I think for most people, they find these feature pages and they're like, oh, cool, photography, and they follow it, and then that's it, you know?
Yeah, no, yeah. For the most part.